And that's Adriano Moraes. This fight brought to you by Naga World, the best business, leisure, and integrated resort in Cambodia. Your final eliminator for the Flyweight Championship. The winner of this takes on Jehe Eustaquio at a date to be announced.
Right away with Moraes, that double leg. Nice double leg. Comes out the back door and on a single now. You know, talking about the height difference, it's not something that Suzuki's not accustomed to. He's always been the shorter fighter, obviously, right? But, I mean, coming off of 5 fights and a win streak, he's found a way to use that to his benefit somewhere. There's a high-level chess game when you have very experienced fighters like this. And Moraes is doing a good job of keeping good pressure. Suzuki's going to want to push on his head, start to post and stand up. You see Moraes dragging him off the fence there.
The Brazilian is a national BJJ champion, I should say.
Well, you know, you look at his corner, one of those guys is a former Abu Dhabi champion. Abu Dhabi is the absolute top shelf of grappling competition. And when you got a guy like that that you're training with every day, you're going to be good on the ground. Speaking of good on the ground, Suzuki's really working on that Kimura. And, you know, a lot of guys use this to sweep guys over. Also, it exposes that left arm, though, of Suzuki. Because if Moraes steps around quick enough, he's going to have access to that top arm of Suzuki's for a straight arm bar. I don't wonder if Moraes forgot that he can just start dropping knees on Suzuki's face from there.
Yeah, good point. He's very exposed, isn't he? His head very exposed to the left knee in particular. There it is.
Well, he also might want to be careful because he's, you know, fairly conscious that that arm. See, you see him just kind of coming around that side.
Just switched around with speed.
You got to be careful on that arm bar. Yeah, I got to be honest. I have not marked my score sheet at all, and I'm probably not going to for this round.
Don't want to take your eyes off it.
This is going to be a great fight. I mean, it's only been 2 minutes in, and already you've seen a ton of action. And you can tell high-level guys, too, because they have such great attention to little details. There's the way Moraes uses his knee on for position and shifts his hip back. How Suzuki's instantly working for submission attempts. And you see Moraes' head is under the armpit of Suzuki. He's going to try to keep that head, keep Suzuki's elbow off the ground. He's going to start to work a head and arm triangle. This could be a bad spot for Suzuki if he's able to clinch this up. But Suzuki smells it.
What does he need to do there, Jason, to push it forward a notch?
Well, Moraes needs to use his head to push Suzuki's arm over his head so that he can trap it, just like a triangle choke, to keep it off the ground. And from here, Suzuki needs to start recomposing, pushing on Moraes' hips just like that. He's recomposing his guard, trying to work in on a front guillotine choke.
Scrambles to his feet, does very well, shows great strength to do that.
Really is a chess game. I mean, we can't really appreciate how technical guys are at a high level like this until you get in there and you really train. You know, people sometimes will watch these fights and they don't understand. They'll ask, why doesn't a guy just do this or that? It's because that other guy just senses an inch of your weight going somewhere and you get thrown, you get submitted. Oh, what a beautiful fireman's carry. I looked up for a brief second. It looked like a fireman's. Ah, there's Moraes with the knees. Moraes has a few options here. He can start to work a choke on the head and arm again, starting to work his body up. He can move into advanced positions like mount. Or he can just sit there and constantly just drill those knees into the body, into the head. Suzuki really has to be active to get Moraes like he's been doing back in guard or butterfly guard.
Oh, to the left, kick to the head.
Timed that perfectly.
Nice takedown.
And you see how Moraes just stays on Suzuki the whole time. Doesn't give him any space. Doesn't back off and re-engage.
Final half minute, Jason. It's been just enthralling.
It has. I'm getting beckoned cage side, pointing at my sheet. Start marking down some takedowns. I'm like, look, I love MMA too much to bring my eyes away from this for a second. This is a big fight. And there's that head and arm choke we talked about. Yuji Shimada's all over this. That looks tight. You see the right hand.
Yuji's asking him.
Oh, he's got 10 seconds. He has to hold this out. Got to make sure he doesn't get... Oh, okay. Oh. I think we should start with the main events and then have a main event after that main event.
What a cracking 5 minutes that was. Absolutely engrossing.
Well, here's one beautiful takedown with that outside leg sweep turned into a double, and then Spun came right out the back door. Very good sense of where he's at. You know, I'd call that a takedown. I'd call that takedown defense, ground control, back and forth both ways. This is exactly the type of fight you don't want to be a judge for, because even though Adriano Moraes has been on top, you've got to give Suzuki credit. He's working from every position. Another just sick money takedown. You know, it's one thing when you see a guy that has a skill set and he's really good at one or two things. But Marias is very sharp with...
Well, you've got eight limbs there working independently to try and gain an advantage. It's a privilege to sit next to Jason and have him take us through it. I just sit back and listen. What a 5 minutes that was. Now, two rounds left. Brief reminder, the winner will face Jehei Eustaquio for the flyweight title. A lot at stake here. And Eustaquio will be watching this, as you said earlier, and thinking to himself, wow, this is a different kind of opponent I'll eventually face to the one I face tonight.
Yeah, Suzuki kind of walks forward flat-footed. He's just... And now he's shuffling. Marias being strategically cautious. Suzuki looked like he started to rev the engine up a little bit there, just was flooring it in neutral.
Whoa, took a hammering to the ring post there. They're well padded, but...
Oh, look at that, and that's a beautiful reversal by Rambo. And another great reverse. This is so fatiguing too, having to have another man's body weight on top of you and have to push. It's not just, you know, like lifting weights or something for 5 minutes. You physically have someone that's countering every move you're making. Mentally fatiguing, physically fatiguing, and even if you're on top there, it's gonna be tough. We got Marias right now with three takedowns. Suzuki's been tough to stop that. Hasn't really found an answer for it yet.
Not many punches have been thrown in this contest, but Marias just threw three to the head of Suzuki.
Oh, he just tried to take the back there. Suzuki had a little window and got up. And I can't really call that a takedown for Suzuki because Marias jumped. He thought he might be able to finish it with a guillotine, but... Yeah, Marias is smart there. He knows he can get kneed and kicked in the head.
Yeah, so he's protecting himself with those, that left hand.
Yeah, those are the little details that when you see high-level guys, that just their instincts are to protect my head. They know when a guy's getting up to throw that kick right away.
There it is. It came in, but it landed... Oh, there. That touched the glove. So if it hadn't been there, that would have been knee to head.
Yeah, and this is a good spot for Suzuki to be in because he knows Marias is going to explode up at some point. He's just going to take a chance and go, now, launch. He's got to explode, but Suzuki's just going to work that thigh while he sits down there and figures out what he wants to do.
Oh,
and a nice switch.
Within the blink of an eye, wasn't it?
That was awesome. Suzuki said, all right, I'm going to try this arm again, working on that Kimura. You know, even if you don't get the Kimura from here, you can get that foot inside and use that as a sweep. I actually used to love that. But it does open up that top arm. Suzuki's so patient, just holding onto that arm. He's just waiting for that moment that Marias is going to give him that 1 or 2 inches or extra couple of ounces off his body weight so that Suzuki can feel an opening and explode into it. Just patient and methodical.
His primary skill is judo.
In ground control, you have to see right now, Marias clearly up. Just been really all over Suzuki, who has been doing a good job of defending, but hasn't been able to mount anything offensively. Starting to work I speak too soon.
Something changes.
Nice. Yeah. Man, just a great job coming out the back door again.
This fight just evolves from one move to another at top speed.
It really does, you know, and it's going to be 5 rounds at top speed. Winner of this fight taking on That's all Yuji wants to see. Boy, how rough is Yuji on guys? Man, you guys breathe.
Yuji should fight for the title. I think he's coming overweight.
Jeez Louise.
Oh. Second time. Great Suzuki wrestling. Suzuki is clattered against the
You know what's funny? I was talking
apron.
To I was talking to Hani, who's one of Marias's training partners, and they were talking about in Brasilia bringing down guys. Oh, you know, we need to bring down guys that can wrestle better. Adriano Moraes' wrestling looks amazing. Like, he's hitting things that are high risk, switches, and not necessarily the switch, but things you don't see in MMA as much. He's in on a guillotine here. This could be a little bit dangerous. I can't really tell from this position if Suzuki has it in deep enough. Oh, nice knee on the way up, too. Caught him flush.
Followed it up with a quick right and left.
Suzuki
that knee was brutal, flying. There was no forward movement, but it came up and really caught him. Talk about ringing your bell.
Man, and good ring sense, too, that both Suzuki went right away for that takedown, and Marias had a beautiful defense.
Wow, what a couple of rounds.
I would not want to be a replay guy right now, just sitting in the booth going, which one of these
which
do I
one?
Pull
yes.
up?
Yeah. Let's just run the whole 5 minutes.
Well, let's take a look at what he wants to see. Here's a nice double leg takedown. You see right away that Suzuki was working in on that top arm. He was looking for that switch right away from the get-go. Marias thought he might have had a guillotine, and a lot of times the guy thinks he has it in deep enough, he may just abandon the takedown and look for it. As Marias is looking for that leg, hits a beautiful switch. Man, that's just textbook money right there. You can keep cashing that check all day. And right here, another awesome switch. Throws the leg over his head.
Well, there's the man who seems to be sitting in pole position.
Seconds out, please.
With an absolute masterclass. But there's no question, Suzuki is making a wonderful fight of this.
Now, please.
Managing his submission defense as best he can. And so far, doing a good enough job to keep this fight alive. Final 5 minutes.
You know, one of the things to look at, too, is that Suzuki has had all of his fights in Shudo. And they judge by a different system than we do here in 1FC. So I wonder if, you know, you just get so ingrained into, okay, I have to do this to win a fight. You're not thinking about the fact that it's not judged by rounds. You actually got to go in there and create some damage. You need to look for that knockout. You know, there's been a couple close submissions. I wouldn't really say it was super near. You know, maybe one or two with that head and arm triangle attempt. And another just great double flare. This is like watching the first round all over again. Double leg flare. Right into that Kimura attempt. Well, Adriano Moraes is showing everybody why he is considered one of the top prospects in the world. Because Kosuke Suzuki is a tough, tough, tough opponent. We talked about already. He's a former 123-pound Shudo rookie champion on a 5-fight win streak. And it almost looks like, you know, Marias is just dominating this fight. Back in on that head and arm attempt.
3.5 minutes left in this contest then.
Oh, this is it. This is that head and arm triangle choke. Oh, you saw there. He almost thought about tapping. It's closed. There it is. It's
there
over.
It is.
This is the man that's going to be fighting for the title against Jay Hay and Stockwheel.
The third time he tried that move, and it eventually paid off. The title shot is his.